year on as their own. Nigel Mansell went on week ago at the French Grand Prix. Can he beat his sworn rival, Nelson Piquet? Well, in qualifying, he couldn't, because it's Nelson Piquet taking pole position in the Cannon Williams Honda at a time of 67.11 seconds. That's a fraction under 106 miles an hour average for the modified circuit. Silverstone is a very, very quick pace indeed. But Mansell was second, it was 67.18 seconds, so 0.07 of a second between them. In fact, Nigel Mansell spun off on his final qualifying effort at that new Whitlock corner in his efforts to knock Nelson Piquet off the curb. So, the Cannon Williams Hondas occupy the front row. It's another Honda-powered car, third quickest, because Ayrton Senna, not quite so happy on the fast circuits with the active suspended Lotus. It was very, very quick in Monte Carlo and Detroit. It's quick enough here to be third fastest, but it's over a second slower than the pole position time. So, Ayrton Senna, third fastest, and Alain Prost, the reigning world champion, fourth fastest. He, too, appreciably slower. In fact, in some of his qualifying, he tried both his cars, but couldn't get close to his best time on Friday, 6.577 seconds. So, the top four in the World Championship, the top four on the starting grid, once again, it's a big top four. It's fifth fastest, Thierry Boutsen, the Belgian this time, 68.972, and Thierry Boutsen trying to better that fifth in Brazil, which is his best finish so far this year. Again, the Benetton's quick, but so far still looking for reliability. But underlining the fact that they're fast, the other Benetton with the Italian Taylor Fabi at the wheel is sixth fastest, just a fraction slower than his Belgian teammate. So the third row of the grid is all Benetton. And Taylor Fabi has finally broken his championship points duck just a week ago. He was fifth in the French Grand Prix. So that's the front three rows. On the fourth row, we have the two Ferraris, Kelly Alboreto, fractionally quicker than Gerhard Berger this week. Let's go on down the grid as the field are led off by the Williams Honda of Nelson Piquet on the final warm-up lap. We see them from the helicopter and now from the ground going around Cox Corner, this long, flat, open circuit, 3 miles of high-speed corners with just the tight kink going into Woodcote, to get them down into second gear. On the fifth row, Andrea Cesaris with the Brabham and Stephanie Hansen with the second McLaren. Row six, Riccardo Petrosi Brabham and Satoru Nakajima. There he is with the camera on the car in the second Lotus Honda. Row seven is the two Arrows, Derek Warwick and Eddie Chiba. Row eight, Nanini's Bernardo, our news this year, and row nine, the two Zatsky. Boots and Alboreto, who is pushing Boots very hard now, and And then a little bit of a gap before we get Taylor Farley, but storming down the main straight and down to Cox much quicker than they used to with the old chicane. They're now approaching Cox at 100 miles an hour. Melbourne to the inside, it goes past Thierry Boutsen. Farley and Cesaris follow, but Ferrari and Alboreto moving up the pace there. And these two Williams Hondas are pulling away. Alain Prost, meanwhile, seems to have settled down and is now starting to challenge Ayrton Senna once more. We've had a change of position for Nakajima and Johansson. Johansson up to ninth, demoting Nakajima to 10th. Nigel Mansell closing a little bit on the leader. And Alain Prost makes an attack at Ayrton Senna, but Senna says no. And all the time, Alboreto in fifth place is closing on. Start once more and watch Alain Prost, who makes a fantastic start from the second row. He changes at the second, but Prost somehow is there, squeezing through on the outside. Mansell falters a little bit. Prost finds himself in the lead, has a big twitch there. You can see it quite clearly as he approaches the apex of Cox, as he comes out of Cox, he's a little bit offline as a result. And Piquet gets it right here, the two are very close as they go down to the left-hander of Maggots. You can see the showers of sparks from Piquet's car, but Piquet has the lead already, and still he has it, as now the cars are on their fourth lap. This is down to Beckett's, Piquet goes through, Mansell goes through, and there's empty road before we get this battle for third place, and still Prost can't do anything about Senna, and he's going to have to do something about it soon, because of the